Graham, the United States is increasing its commitment to rescue those Nigerian schoolgirls. Our country is deploying 80 military personnel to Africa to help find the 275 girls kidnapped by the Islamic terrorist group Boko Haram. Meanwhile, the U.S. lawmakers are pressing the Obama administration to do even more to bring the girls home. Our Mark Martin has the story.
A young Nigerian girl tells a heart-wrenching story to the House Foreign Affairs panel about a Boko Haram attack on her family home.
They shoot my dad in his chest 3 times, so my dad was, he fell that I started moving. So my brother was in shock, you know, like, start yelling at them that, what did my dad do to you? Why do you kill my dad?
Deborah Peters says several members of the group came to their door and demanded the father renounce his Christian faith. The survivor says they did not stop there.
They shoot my brother 2 times, and when they shoot my brother, that's when my dad died, and then my brother fell, and he was moving. They shoot in his mouth, then he died.
We care about Deborah, her friends and family. We care about a girl's right to an education. We care about human rights and religious liberty and the future of Africa's largest country.
Deborah is a native of the town where the nearly 300 schoolgirls were kidnapped. To help the rescue effort, the Obama administration is sending some 80 military personnel and an unarmed Predator aircraft to neighboring Chad. The mostly Air Force personnel will fly and monitor reconnaissance aircraft and also provide ground security. In a letter to U.S. lawmakers, President Obama said the U.S. will remain there until our support is no longer needed to bring the girls home. A senior defense official says the mission is not to get Boko Haram, but to get the girls. Mark Martin, CBN News.